Hey, brothers and sisters, I'm on here tonight, this afternoon, while I was praying. The Lord was showing me all this stuff. And, of course, I had to go to the grocery store and stuff there. Right after I got finished praying, I didn't have time to make a video. So I just was praying just a few minutes before I started making this video, and the Lord is just speaking to me now, and I just hear the word destruction, destruction, destruction. If you guys know, you watch my videos, I don't usually say stuff like that. I don't usually say stuff like that. Of course, we know about the tribulation, right? And this is what the Lord showed me this afternoon. I'm going to tell you exactly what I saw. Sometimes I give an explanation, and sometimes I just say straight up what the Lord showed me. And some of you guys, if I know the meaning, I do. If I don't, I don't. So anyway, this afternoon while I was praying, I saw President George Washington wearing his Masonic apron. And a special one, a dressed up one, not the regular one. See, there's the regular lambskin apron, a white one. When you go to Masonic Lodge, actually, the Masonic Lodge, you wear like a cloth one when you go to the regular meetings. Just a cloth white one. They have these, the officers of the lodge have these ones with different color designs on it, you can see. And then when you die, if you're an active Mason, and then you die, they have a lambskin. You know, when you become a master Mason, they call it being raised. Being raised from the dead symbolically in Masonry. And that's why it's not really good, because in Masonry they have it that King Solomon raises people from the dead in Masonry. So when you become raised, is what they call it, to become a master Mason, you're raised up. They give you this lambskin apron that you're supposed to save, and then when you die you'll be buried in it. But anyway, in my vision, I saw George Washington. He was wearing a special ceremonial lambskin apron. There's paintings of him laying the cornerstone, like at the Capitol building and stuff like that. And I'm not sure exactly, the apron was similar to that, but I didn't say that it was that picture. I didn't see the Capitol building or nothing like that. He's wearing a ceremonial Masonic apron. And then he was wearing these white gloves too, brothers and sisters. And in my vision, it zoomed in on those white gloves. Particularly something that the Lord was emphasizing. And I'll just say this, FYI, if you have a dream or a vision, and you know, it's like you try to remember every detail of your dream, just like in the parables of the Lord and in the Bible about dreams, not every single detail means something. You know, a parable means thrown alongside of. It's a comparison. It doesn't have to be exactly every detail is translated. Okay? But the main things, like when you have a dream, the part that's so important to you, like if you saw, you know, a dream of someone's wearing a red hat, and it's like, oh, you're obsessed with, what does it mean, the red hat? Well, the color red is so important. But that what style of hat might not mean anything. It could be a cowboy hat, a baseball cap. That may not make any difference at all. But the Lord wanted you to know it's a red, and it's something that covers your head. You see what I'm saying? That is a hat. You know what I'm saying? Okay. Now, if he emphasized, you see that, oh, it's a baseball cap. I definitely remember that it was a red baseball cap. Okay. There's a connection there. Something to do with what would you get from a baseball cap and the fact that it's red. FYI, brothers and sisters, because the Lord, we all prophesy in part. We all get words from the Lord and dreams and visions. As the Lord said, he would pour out his spirit on all flesh. You know, your sons and daughters will prophesy. Your old men will dream dreams. Your young men will prophesy. All of that from Joel chapter 2, Acts chapter 2. So lots of people have dreams and even visions and stuff. They just don't tell nobody because people think, oh, they're crazy or whatever. So that's why, you know, I'm just throwing these things out as the Lord leads me, that you will, you know, have the desire to get the interpretation and understand what the Lord's trying to show you. Anyway, brothers and sisters, so I saw this George Washington, a special ceremonial lambskin apron, had lots of design on it and stuff, but I didn't recognize it specifically. So in other words, the Lord wanted me to see that it was a special ceremonial lambskin apron and his white gloves. The Lord zoomed in on the fact, and I saw it zoomed in, those white gloves. It means something. Okay. And then I saw a building, not the cornerstone, but I saw the point of a building where, like, if you stood at a building and looked at a building, it was like a tall building. I don't know how many stories, but, you know, it wasn't one, two, or three stories. It might have been 10 stories or 20 stories or whatever, a tall building. And then it might have been, it was gray color, and I don't know if that mattered. And it came to a point in a corner, and like I was focusing on the corner. So to me, I said to myself, and I'm not sure if it was from the Lord or my own mind, you know, cornerstone. Because George Washington wore a special ceremonial lambskin apron when they laid the cornerstone of buildings. That's what Masons do, they lay cornerstones of buildings. But what also came to mind was Nicholas Rorick. as I mentioned him in videos before, go look him up. Nicholas Rorick and Henry Wallace. Rorick was the guru, a New Age, satanically inspired child of the devil who put all this New Age junk out that America would be the new Atlantis and all this stuff. And he had this little coffin thing that he carried around, and there was a debate what was in there. It was supposed to be something like power in there. So the debate was, you know, is it the Holy Grail? Is it the, you know, they tried to say it was the stone that's, you know, Jacob rested his head on. Well, of course it wouldn't be there. There's a painting. I'm touching on all this information that's connected to this, and I don't know how, brothers and sisters. That's why I'm telling you these details, because the Lord gave me all the stuff, and I have no idea how it's connected. Time is short, and I'm just throwing it out there. Those have been following my videos. There's something called, I believe it's called the Shepherds. There's a painting, and it shows like, what is it like Jacob and maybe the tomb of Joseph, and it's called the Shepherd's Chapel. Anyway, there's a place called the Shepherd's Chapel. There's a painting called the Shepherd's Chapel. It's in the back of this big estate. And there's a guy who is the expert code cracker. The guy's probably in his 50s or 60s. He's the expert code cracker. He even had a public, a press conference saying what this, you know, all the geometry that's in that painting is supposed to be some, you know, secret meaning to it. And all this is all interconnected, brothers and sisters. Sir Francis Bacon trying to bring forth, you know, United States, the New World as the New Atlantis. And the symbol on the back of the dollar bill, all these things are connected, and I don't really know how, brothers and sisters, like I say. I'm just throwing it out there. On the back of the dollar bill, as I mentioned before, Doc Marquis, the Lord led me to him. What he says about the back of the dollar bill, the great seal and all that, there's the answer to the Illuminati, and all that is in there. Okay. And what's their plan? Okay, and the Lord gave me something else. I'm getting to it. Take that backwards from Doc Marquis, what he shows on there. Nicholas Rorick was the guru of Henry Wallace. Henry Wallace was the Secretary of Agriculture under Roosevelt. They were both 32nd or 33rd degree Masons. They put the symbol on the dollar bill. Before that, that symbol, the Great Seal of the United States, was not on the back of the dollar bill. They added it in the 1930s under the inspiration of this guy, the guru of Nicholas Rorick. The guru's name is Nicholas Rorick. Nicholas Rorick was all over Europe, and he went to the Tibetan monks and all this stuff and whatever. Anyway, but the pillow that Jacob rested his head on is actually supposed to be, in legend, the Stone of Scone, which is where all the royals of Europe are inaugurated on. Queen Elizabeth was inaugurated with that stone under her throne. They just recently, a few years ago, gave it back to Scotland. It belonged to Scotland, and then the British took it from them 500 years ago or 700 years ago, whatever it was. Supposedly bought by Joseph of Arimathea, Mary Magdalene, up there to Scotland, and then that's why those people claim this bloodline. It all ties back into the Da Vinci Code lie. You know, the bloodline of the Messiah, the Holy Grail, is the bloodline of Jesus. That their lie is that Jesus had a girlfriend or a wife, Mary Magdalene, and she had children. That's the lie of the devil. When that book came out, the Da Vinci Code, I didn't care nothing about it. There was lots of preachers, famous PhD preachers who did books against the Da Vinci Code. I knew it was a lie. I didn't care to even get into it because that's not, you know, God didn't call me to get into that. But the Lord spoke to me when the Da Vinci Code came out and said, this is a lie straight from Satan. And this is a very important book and a very important thing connected with the work of Satan. And that's all the Lord told me that at that time. And, you know, I was like, okay, I will tell people it's demonic. But I didn't understand that, hey, this is really pointing to the Antichrist. But anyway, brothers and sisters, next in my vision, after I saw that, I saw that corner of a building, but not just a cornerstone, but like the hole where the building comes to a point, all like the whole wall of the point, the corner of a building. And I said to myself, as I mentioned, the cornerstone and all the things I just told you connected with the Masonic ceremony of laying cornerstone. I didn't add this. Nicholas Rorick supposedly took that little casket, little coffin that he carried with some powerful magic object in there, something to do, you know, with the Bible, allegedly, which is a lie. Gave him some magical power, and nobody knows what was in there. He's got paintings he drew of himself carrying that thing with magic power in it, like the Ark of the Covenant-like thing, power coming out of it. He put that in the cornerstone of a building in New York City. That building is still there. I cannot think of the name of it. There's a woman who is the head of the, she's like the super, as they call it up there in New York, the super of the building, superintendent. And she was a young woman. She's been living there for 50 or 60 or 70 years. This old lady was living there at the time that Nicholas Rorick was still alive. And somebody tried to break in there into the cornerstone of that building and steal that thing, and they were found dead. I think it was it wasn't Nicholas Roerich's son. I can't remember now. It's been a long time. I saw the documentary on that. You're going to Google it. You'll find the documentary on this stuff. And I think Chris Pinto did that. It's excellent. The Lord led me to watch all these things. It's all interconnected, brothers and sisters. And so then after the Lord showed me that, he showed me, someone just sent me a magazine cover from 1971 or 1974, and it shows an eagle, like a big eagle with a crown that's a fleur-de-lis on it. Somebody just sent me that the other day. I've seen that one time before. Anyway, the symbol for a 33rd degree Mason, brothers and sisters, and a 32nd degree Mason, is this double-headed eagle. Now, you see the symbol of the Romanovs and some of these other countries. There's a double-headed eagle. I haven't really studied it too much. I guess it's like a phoenix or whatever, the rise of the phoenix and all that. As a matter of fact, the video that I'm thinking of, the documentary that I'm just telling you about, see, I didn't even realize that till just now as I'm speaking. The name of the documentary about the stuff of Nicholas Roerich and all this, something about the rise of the phoenix or something about the phoenix. So anyway, the double-headed eagle or phoenix, which is supposed to be on the seal of the dollar, is also the phoenix. Not an eagle, but a phoenix, brothers and sisters. He's got this little feather up on his head. So the phoenix bird is like a bird that dies and then rises out of the flame. The new world order, a new rebirth by fire instead of by the Lord. You know, it's a satanic type of a gospel and rebirth thing. Like in Masonry, even at the Master Mason level, you die, you're killed symbolically, and then they raise you from the dead symbolically in the third degree. So you're resurrected, but not by the power of the Lord, but by the power of King Solomon. That's the story of Masonry. Anyway. So then the Lord showed me, I saw that double-headed eagle of Masonry, of the 32nd degree, and I guess 33rd degree too, of Masonry. And then, brothers and sisters, it started looking like the one from that magazine cover, which is a single-headed eagle with a fleur-de-lis on top of it. And I heard this, brothers and sisters, this is the most important part of this video. There's something I've never said and I've never heard, I don't know, but I already knew this idea, but the Lord spoke it to me today, that when you see the one world currency. When you see the one world currency, know that this Antichrist kingdom is at hand, and the Antichrist kingdom will come forward first as a government system, and then the Antichrist will come out of that. So what we're about to see, brothers and sisters, some way, somehow, how it all come together, of course the details is, you know, the devil's in the details. We will see a global currency being born. When we see that, when you see the global currency being born, know that the Antichrist is near, even at the door, that the time of the rapture is, you know, is there's no sign for the rapture. The rapture has been imminent. It's always imminent. There's no date, sign, or nothing to connect when the rapture is. But the rapture will be before the Antichrist signs that seven-year, confirms that seven-year covenant to rebuild the temple on the Temple Mount, to divide the land of Israel, as it tells us throughout the Old Testament, like in Joel and other places. When that deal is going to come forth to divide the land, of course, that is the beginning. When that deal is made, it's a seven-year agreement. That is the beginning of the tribulation. But before that, brothers and sisters, that's what the Lord is telling me. Before that, we will see the rise of the one world system, the beast system, not the Antichrist himself, the son of perdition, but his kingdom will rise first, and then the Antichrist will come forward. And the Lord, you know, there's Bible verses for that, and it's not in my mind exactly what they are now, but it says that, you know, about the 10 kingdoms, and then 3 will be, you know, the little horn will come up after 3 is removed and all that. So there's some Antichrist is about to appear. We're going to see that, brothers and sisters. We're going to see that. So how can a new world currency come? As I said, destruction, destruction, destruction is what the Lord told me tonight, right before I made this video. And all the other stuff I was telling you is what he told me a few hours, about 6 hours ago. Destruction, destruction, destruction is coming. So I think the Lord is saying, and what I'm saying is that we're going to see a destruction. There's going to have to be some chaos. As that saying on the back of the dollar bill comes from the Kume Sibyl, and it's spoken by a demon or a satanically possessed oracle. I like the Oracle of Delphi. This is a Kume Sibyl, and they gave this poem, these oracles, from Apollo, Apollyon, from the book of Revelation. Who is the captain over the bottomless pit? Who is the spirit of Antichrist, the fallen angel who will possess or is the Antichrist? And the whole sentence is, out of chaos, a new world order is born, or a birth of a new world order. So the chaos is coming. That's why they're letting all these illegal immigrants in the United States. God bless you guys. I want to say this too. I'll mention it again. If you're in Vancouver, I've got several people in Vancouver area that's already contacted me. In the month of August, I will be in Portland, Oregon. By the grace of God, I'll be in Portland, Oregon, Seattle, and Vancouver. I need you to contact me. I already got several people. I'm trying to get it more organized than I normally do. So please contact me. We're getting it set up. We'll be doing baptisms in all three places. If you need to be baptized, you can meet me in Portland. You can meet me in Seattle. You can meet me in Vancouver. Maybe even somewhere in between. I can stop on the way for a few minutes and baptize somebody, meet somebody, pray with them, whatever. Somewhere on the road. I'll be flying to Portland and renting a car and driving up to Seattle, Vancouver, and back. And so if you're in between along that highway, Interstate 5, you could possibly meet two along the way. God bless you guys.